So at Mobile World Congress, Canonical kind of launched or announced Ubuntu on Android.
They did indeed, and Ubuntu on Android I think is really exciting. And in a different interview, you asked me a lot about laptops. And, you know, quite frankly, ARM laptops are kind of exciting, but I think really the most exciting thing is going to be Ubuntu for Android, because in the future, as the chips get more and more powerful, we talked about these powerful chips going into servers, those same powerful chips are going to go into phones. And the really cool thing about that is, at some point, the power of your phone becomes as good or better than the current laptops. The only difference is the interface size is, you know, kind of small. It's a phone. But with Ubuntu for Android, you can dock the phone, put it into a dock with a keyboard and a display, or just attach it via HDMI and a Bluetooth keyboard, and you put it on a monitor. And now all of a sudden, you've got the power of a high-end ARM chip, both doing your phone. You can still answer the phone, you can still call your contacts, but now you can run all of your applications that you normally have on your laptop, you can run them right on the phone. The beauty is now all of your data is in one place, not scattered on your laptop, some on your phone, some on a different machine. It's all in your phone. You back up your phone, you're done. And the beauty is you can either carry the dock or maybe in an office environment, right, you've got your phone, but when you get to work, you dock your phone, and in your office space, you've got docks that are empty, and you can move from desk to desk. You can go to a conference like this, and they might have 30 or 40 docks out, and you dock your phone, and you're ready to go. And so I really think that Ubuntu for Android is a very exciting product, because it enables you to take huge advantage of the power that's in these new phones that are coming and get both your phone functionality and get full Ubuntu functionality in one place.
So you need to modify the firmware to support Ubuntu? Or is it possible to make it in a way that it could work in theory and maybe on any Android device?
Well, it does require some special sauce into Android so that all your data gets back and forth. So when you're on your Android phone and you dock it, all of your contacts become available in Ubuntu. And if you edit the contact, it then becomes back available in Android when you undock. That does require some extra stuff into Android that's not currently there. So that's going to be the way it is, because you can today, on some high-powered phones, you can have a shroud of Ubuntu running, but it doesn't share data. And really, that's the sauce that we've worked very hard on, both on the Ubuntu side, but also on the Android side, to make this cross-data situation work, so that you have the same contacts, your email automatically sets up in Ubuntu, and if you draft an email in Ubuntu and you stop, undock, the draft becomes available in your Android mail client. And conversely, if you're working on an email in Android, dock your phone, it now becomes available in Ubuntu. That's a lot of sauce, a lot of work that goes into that. But like I say, you could, and I've certainly seen people do this already, put Ubuntu by itself as a shroud on an Android phone, and it works, but it doesn't share the data. I think the real super part about the Ubuntu for Android is sharing that data, so it's a seamless environment for the end user to have their data and use it where they want, not, well, I can run it in Ubuntu, but then I can't get to my contacts out of Android, or vice versa.
So to update Ubuntu, you would just have to update the Ubuntu app on Android?
The Ubuntu would still update the normal way. It's apt-get or through the updater. It would notify you when the updates for it, and it would update just the way it does today.
Does it need to take up more of the ROM space or some?
Well, yeah, of course it has to take up some more storage. I mean, you can't get something for nothing. Yeah. Ubuntu needs to have some storage room, and it would go on there.
The
and then there's shared data space.
Similar size, like 700 megabytes and that?
I don't know off gigabytes? The top of my head. Yeah. It'll be similar, but I don't know the exact numbers, quite frankly.
So this is like just about to be ready, or it takes some time and still?
There's a huge amount of excitement, and there's a bunch of phone folks and OEMs and ODMs that are very interested. We will have our release, our full 1.0 release very soon, and then, you know, how soon it'll be to be on phones very shortly, but I don't know the exact numbers.